It's Wednesday, June 13th, and your stories today are a Wells Fargo ban, Apple revises guidelines, and in EU, Ask Me Anything. World, you're watching the comments on ETH News. For your first story today, Wells Fargo announced that they are no longer allowing customers to purchase cryptocurrency with their Wells Fargo credit cards. The decision was made out of concern that clients will not be able to pay back creditors due to the volatile nature of crypto markets. Wells Fargo released a statement about the ban on their website saying, quote, "We're doing this in order to be consistent across the Wells Fargo enterprise due to the multiple risks associated with this volatile investment. This decision is in line with the overall industry. We will continue to evaluate the issue as the market evolves." Unquote. Wells Fargo is not the first institution to ban credit card purchases of crypto. Earlier this year, JP Morgan, Citi, and Bank of America all amended their respective policies, and for good reason. We shouldn't get into debt buying crypto, right? You should never invest with credit. I mean, remember, invest within your means. In other news, Apple has revised its guidelines for development of cryptocurrency mining apps. Moving forward, developers are asked to design their app for power efficiency. Apple's website stated, quote, "Apps should not rapidly drain battery, generate excessive heat, or put unnecessary strain on device resources. Apps, including any third-party advertisements displayed within them, may not run unrelated background processes such as cryptocurrency mining." Unquote. The move seems to tackle the issue of crypto mining and aims to improve performance of apps and increase the longevity of Apple devices' lifecycle, which is great. No one should be mining crypto on your device without your knowledge. But I'm pretty sure most of Apple's battery life issues occur right about 18 months after purchase, just coincidentally as the new iPhone model is being introduced. In fact, the company admitted that software updates make your phone operate more slowly to offset problems with the aging lithium-ion battery. So, while you're so valiantly protecting consumers from illicit crypto mining, maybe you can protect them from your software updates and cheap batteries too. And finally, the European Union Blockchain Observatory and Forum announced that it is hosting a 90-minute Ask Me Anything session on June 18th. The organization plans to engage with the public to address any concerns about blockchain technology and the future plans for the EU in the space. The agenda for the AMA will focus on blockchain education, use cases, future expectations, and a section dedicated to the hard questions. Formally launched in February, the observatory focuses on developing blockchain-based applications, such as for cross-border remittance that can contribute to European markets. That's our comment for the day, but what do you think? Are banks wrong for banning credit card purchases of crypto? Is Apple really looking out for us or just covering their own butts? And will you be asking any tough questions during the AMA? Let me know what you think. Tweet at me. Have a wonderful day. Don't forget to follow us on YouTube. And don't forget to leave a comment. Join me back here on The Comment as I catch you up on the latest in Ethereum and blockchain. If you like this episode, let me know by clicking the thumbs up. If you didn't like this episode, let me know by clicking the thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Make sure you get all the newest episodes of The Comment as they air by clicking that alert button. That's that bell-looking thing next to the word subscribe. If you miss our latest episodes, you can catch up on ethnews.com or on YouTube, or just subscribe so you don't miss them anymore, silly. Follow me on Twitter and Instagram at ethnewsy. That's at ethnewsy. And we'll see you next time.